If you want to embed a URL in the middle of a form, you have come to the right place. I'm going to be walking through the exact steps that you can take in order to do this using two tools. I'm going to be in Airtable and JotForm. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business using no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, definitely check out all the links around this entire video. And I would like to personally invite you to join me for my upcoming live automation webinar. Once a week, I hop on a live webinar and I teach the basic steps of using automation, building automation so that it will run your business for you on autopilot. Now, if this is of interest, I personally save up to 20 hours per week and I want to help you do the same. So check out that webinar link that you see below, or visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration to get all signed up. And hey, even if you can't attend live, I'll send you a replay so you can always check that out. But without further ado, let's jump into the heart of this video. We're talking about embedding code, embedding an iframe directly inside of a form. Now we're gonna be using JotForm for the form because JotForm is a robust form element. And although Airtable does have forms, they're not quite as capable as a true form tool like JotForm. But on the other end, we are gonna be storing some data and information in Airtable. So let's hop on into it. The first part that I've got here is my Airtable structure. Now I'm imagining that we have a form that is asking people for their location, and depending on the location, then a certain selection here might be available to them. For example, I have imagined that there are 5 different mobile dog groomers that serve a general area, but that each of them has specific zip codes that it can go to. So depending on the zip code that somebody fills out on the form, that will then eliminate some of these mobile groomers from the possible pool that they can pick from. Inside of our data set, you'll see that we have the phone number, a website, and of course we also have a button that is just referencing the website. So that if somebody pushes that button, it'll take them to that website. And then of course we also have those zip codes that that particular vendor services. Then we build out some additional views. Each of these views has its own filter that eliminate any of the other vendors that don't service that particular zip code. So ideally we would do this for every single zip code. So let's go ahead and build the next one now. We can start with our most recent one, which has a filter applied to the 80122 zip code. And we can simply duplicate this view, rename it to be the next upcoming zip code, 80123, go to our filter, make the slight change, and then there we have it. Just those particular vendors that service this new zip code. Now, let's take a look at the form itself. Inside of our form, we ask the basic information up front: name, email, zip code, pretty standard. Then we have a particular page that is only for the 80121 zip code, and you see that it has the iframe embedded here that includes just the view that I referenced earlier. Flipping back to Airtable, we have that 80121 view, and of course we can share that view, embed that view on our site, and then embed that right into our form. So going back to our form now, we can see then if we scroll down, we have the same thing for 80122, and ultimately we would build this for every single zip code in the overall serviced area. So let's go ahead and build that now for 80123. I'm going to add a new page here, and inside of this page I can duplicate these elements. So I'll just click on here, right click, duplicate, and I can drag it down to my new page. Similarly, I can grab that embed code, duplicate it, and also drag it down to my new page. Now, if this is the first time that you're installing this piece, what you'll need to do is go to the widgets and just look up embed, or you can look up iframe here, and there is an embed iframe widget that you can just add, and that's exactly what this is here. Now what we need to do is change this page for that new zip code, in our case 80123. So of course we want to label the header appropriately, but also we need to make sure that this particular iframe is looking at the right embedded iframe from Airtable. So let's flip back to Airtable. We go to our 80123 view here. Remember, this one is now filtered for that current zip code, and we click on the share view option. Create a shareable grid view link, This, of course, is a read-only link. And we don't want to actually grab this URL right here. What we want to do is embed the view on our site. This takes us to the pre-packaged embed code, that iFrame embed code. But if we install this full piece, this will actually not work. What we're looking for is the exact URL right here as the source code for this iFrame. So grab that URL just right there inside of those double quotations, and let's now flip back into JotForm, and we'll go into our widget settings for this particular zip code. Inside of our widget settings, we have our frame URL, and we can just paste that right here. And you see that instantly, once we update the widget, this is now updated to reflect that current zip code. So if we were to double check, this one has two particular vendors, in this case, Soapy Puppies and Dapper Doggies. We can flip over to that iFrame view, and sure enough, those are the two vendors that we see here that service this particular zip code. Cool. Now the last piece, of course, is to build some conditional logic in our form so that our users only see those iframes that relate to their specific zip code. So in order to do that, let's flip into the settings of our form, go on the left-hand side to our conditions, and we can build a new rule that says under certain conditions, we want to see that new page. So we can skip or hide a page. Specifically, we're looking to see what the zip code is equal to. If it equals 80123, then we want to go ahead and skip to the new page that we just built, or page 4. We will then save this, and let's take this out for a spin to make sure that yes, in fact, it works the way we would expect. So we'll go ahead and publish this and open this in a new tab and test this out. Irrelevant what we put in for our name and email, but let's go and look at that 80123. If we do select that, we are then redirected to the mobile groomers for that particular zip code, and we see the iframe that comes from our Airtable database. Now, the reason this is so clean is as we make changes to our data source, that will be instantly reflected here. So if a new vendor decides to service this area, let's go back to our records in Airtable. Suppose this vendor Scrub-a-Dub-Dog starts servicing that area. I can add that zip code to their service radius, and then inside of my form, if I were to fill this out again, 80123, when I go there, you see that that new vendor is instantly reflected here. So all of our data is talking, and then as a last step, our users could just click next and go through whatever the remaining steps of the form are. So I hope you see how this is an incredibly valuable tool. Being able to embed information in a JotForm form and make it so that it is conditionally viewed based upon what people have entered previously in the form. It's a really powerful tool that will allow you to do a lot with your end users as they interact with your form. I hope you got a ton of value out of this. Check out the links below if you're curious to learn more, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.